The Nantucket Sleighride, the Frankie Ransom Series, Book 3. Written by James Philip. Narrated by Lesley Parkin. They were losing it. This was going wrong. Panic wasn't going to help. The thing was to adjust, refocus. They'd built slippage into the plan. This was still doable. She checked her watch. The man was stabbing at the canvas now, progressing down the side of the ornate oak frame with a series of slashing, carving motions, beginning to see the end. Two sides of the giant painting hung jaggedly, flapping across his head and shoulders.
4 minutes, the woman said.
I can probably rip this thing out, the man suggested. His breath came in hard, gulping gasps. What do you think?
Do it.
She wanted to delay another week. Give him longer to recuperate from his injuries. He'd inherited his stubbornness from his bitch mother. Fortunately, none of her legendary meanness. A quick check of the watch. It was going to take too long to cut out the painting. They could hunker down, wait it out until the guards had come and gone. They might get lucky. No, whatever happened, they couldn't get caught until the thing was done.
Do it now!
The man dropped the box cutter, took a fierce grip of the free corner of the canvas and pulled. To their surprise, the painting peeled away from the frame instantly, so easily that he tottered on the chair, lost his balance and tumbled to the floor, grunting with pain. Part of the picture's frame had disintegrated. A panel had smashed down across his face. The woman ignored his groans. She began to roll the torn canvas as she dragged it across the room. She dumped it, still attached to the piece of splintered frame, in the tall cylindrical waste bin in the middle of the floor. She pulled the lighter fuel dispenser out of her pocket, splashed the contents over the canvas, reached for her matches, struck one, and dropped it in the bin. And in her dreams, she set fire to the greatest surviving masterpiece of the New England school. She stepped back, tried to imagine the Nantucket Sleighride burning. She glared at her watch.
Fuck!
What?
We just got caught again.
The man hesitated. Maybe we get lucky next time. The woman stepped over to the light switches. They blinked at each other in the stark illumination, glanced around at the canvases stacked against the walls. Their eyes turned back to the acrid grey smoke pouring from the bin, filling the room. She snatched the CO2 extinguisher they'd pre-positioned beside the burning bin, killed the fire in seconds.
Since when do we get that lucky?